And now, please welcome the Bronx Community College faculty.
I start now? Is it on?
President Second Egbe, assembled before you are the candidates for degrees, their families, friends, distinguished guests, our faculty and staff, members of the administration, and our alumni. I request your permission now to open the proceedings of the 63rd Commencement Exercise of Bronx Community College.
All right, well, I know you all are thrilled that today is commencement day. Can I get a, oh yeah?
Oh yeah!
Oh, that's right, I feel it in the air already. Good morning, everyone, and you may have a seat. Does it feel like a Bronx Community College commencement day, yes or no?
Yeah.
I feel it too. Good morning, everyone. I am Dr. Manny Lopez, Associate Dean for Student Development here at Bronx Community College. Yes, it is my distinct pleasure to serve as your Master of Ceremony at this 63rd Commencement exercise. During this time, during this ceremony, feel free to tweet, Instagram, Snapchat, Facebook, and all that other fun social media activity during today's social media. It's welcomed, and you are encouraged to do so, please. Be sure to add the hashtags BCC2023 and BCC CUNY to whatever you post. Also, in case you didn't know, we are live streaming on the BCC homepage right now. So if you have loved ones or friends or somebody who just didn't want to come or couldn't make it, which would be surprising to me, tell them to log on to the BCC webpage and they'll watch us live stream at this moment. While I encourage you to tweet and all that other fun social media stuff, please be reminded to silence your cell phones for the duration of this program. That's clear, yes? This year, student Donald Flowers will sing the national anthem, accompanied on the guitar by Professor Benjamin Yarmolinsky. Before I would like to take a moment and announce that after 26 years of teaching, Professor Yarmolinsky is retiring. That's the way I felt. Professor Yarmolinsky started in the Department of Art and Music as an adjunct instructor at BCC in 1997 and became full-time shortly thereafter. Throughout his career, he has composed a large body of work consisting of operas, film scores, chamber music, and many songs. His retirement plans, including traveling, hiking, and creating more original music. Thank you, Professor, for all your years of service to the students and the college. I know I asked you all to have a seat, but I'm going to ask you to please stand for the national anthem and the invocation. Thank you.
By the dawn's early light, was so proudly hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. Oh, the ramparts we watched was so gallantly streaming, and the Rockies' red glare of bursting in air gave through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave? Oh, the land of the free. Congratulations to all the graduates.
That was absolutely lovely. Please remain standing for the invocation. Exercise, people, exercise. Come on. Rabbi Bob Kaplan, please come to the podium to deliver the invocation. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Wow. It is a distinct honor to be here with all of you today for two reasons. One is 75 years ago, my father stood where you guys are standing right now, son of immigrants, just returned from World War II when this was NYU campus, and graduated, the first one in his family to graduate college in, well, can't tell you how many thousands of years. And his light and his smile is shining on all of you today, because when God created the world, he created, it says in Scripture, two lights, one greater, one smaller, the sun and the moon. Well, today, there's a third light been created. It's all of you. It's the light that's shining out of each and every one of you right now. That is so filled with power and hope. And I use that word hope for a very distinct reason, because each and every one of you is a symbol of hope and the world that is to be made through your efforts in partnership with our common Creator. In my faith tradition, when there is a special day like this, we say something called Hallel, which means to praise. And in the Hebrew, it says, Zehayom asadanoi nagila v'nismachabo. This is the day that God has created. Rejoice in it. Rejoice in your accomplishments, and rejoice in all of what you do. The other thing that comes out of our faith tradition is another from Psalm 18. And it's a blessing that I want to leave with you. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his face to you and give you peace. But one more admonition, an article of faith. It's not just the Lord giving you peace. It's now your responsibility as graduates, and you'll all be handed your diplomas in just a little bit. But your job as graduates is to be partners with our common Creator and creating peace in this world. In this world that is so racked by just incredible division and toxicity, your job as the next generation of leaders is to bring peace into the world. That will be your partnership with our common Creator, however you connect or worship that common Creator.
So my blessing to you is to become partners, partners with each other, partners with peace, partners in creating a better world for all of us. And 75 years from now, one of yours will stand in front of others and say, "The smile and the light of my parent is with you today."
Thank you so much, Rabbi Kaplan. That was lovely. And I couldn't agree more. Thousands of BCC lights are on this field today. So give yourselves another round of applause. So that we can remain fluidity and consistency in the program, just a few suggestions, please. We ask that you remain in your seats during the entire ceremony so that we can ensure safety for all and move through the commencement exercise as smoothly as possible. Out of respect to your fellow graduates, we request that you stay until the end of the ceremony. Everyone's equally important here. To encourage you to remain for the full ceremony, we have a special graduation gift and your diploma cover that will be distributed only at the end of the ceremony. And I'm not going to tell you where it's at until the end of the ceremony. While I'm up here, I would like to take a moment and introduce the other members of the platform party. Platform guests, as I call your name, please stand. You can stand and sit. No need to remain standing. Graduates, please hold your applause until the end of all introductions. Professor Ronnie Benoon, Chair of the Faculty Senate. Dr. Lester Rapallo, Provost and Vice President for Academic Affairs. Dr. Lester Sanders Rapallo. New York State Attorney General Letitia James. Now, I'm going to tell you, after we let folk know that you're going to be our keynote speaker, all of a sudden, a lot more cap and gowns were sold. I don't know why, but that just happened. It's the truth. City of New York trustee, Fernando Ferrer. Miss Ika Ekinadose, Elizabeth Asemota, valedictorian. Miss Ruby Lauren Kent, salutatorian. Those are our students, by the way, so give it up for them at the end. Miss Sierra Moncayo, Student Government Association President. Miss Susan Fiore, Executive Legal Counsel and Department of Labor Designee. Dr. Eddie Baradell, Vice President for Advancement, Communications, and External Relations. Rabbi Bob Kaplan, who you've already met. Dr. Paul J. Jaram, Faculty Grand Marshal. Reverend James Sheehan, who will be providing our benediction today. Dr. Milton Santiago, Interim Vice President for Finance and Administration. Dr. Bernard Gant, Vice President for Enrollment Management. Dr. Alex Ott, tallest man on the campus and Associate Dean for Curriculum Matters and Academic Programs. Mr. Michael Williams, second tallest man, president of the BCC Alumni Foundation. Ms. Catherine McGuire, board member of the BCC Auxiliary Enterprises. Bronx Borough President, Honorable Vanessa Gibson. New York State Assembly Member Yudelka Tapia. New York City Council Member Perina Sanchez. Graduates, several of our distinguished guests who are here today will bring you greetings and good wishes. Now, is everyone still with me, yes or no?
Yes.
I have a little exercise for you. It's easy. I hope you enjoy it. I'm going to do a test, or I'm going to test your enthusiasm for your graduation in today's ceremony. I want to feel your energy and know that you are excited to be here today. This exercise is mandatory for graduates, but everyone, including loved ones and folk on this stage, can participate. It's a simple exercise, and it goes like this. I'm going to ask you a question and ask you to respond appropriately. So when I ask, who are we, you're going to yell back, BCC. Simple, yes? All right. So we're going to do this at least three times or until the folk at Lehman could hear us. One time. If you do it the first time, it's a wrap. You know what? I'm going to take on that deal. If you knock down the house the first time, we don't have to do it three times. All right? All right. Here we go. One, two, three. Who are we? Go. Don't need to respond to that, right? Yes, yes, yes. Yes, we are BCC. And someone who will always be BCC is our president, Dr. Thomas Sekinegbi. Not yet, sir, not yet. As some of you may know, Dr. Sekinegbi has decided that this year will be his last ceremony as BCC president. With that, I'd like to highlight some of his notable accomplishments as the president of Bronx Community College. President Sekinegbi has navigated students, faculty, and staff through the pandemic, helping to provide the tools, tactics, training, and support necessary for successful learning in an online environment and pivot to hybrid and high-flex learning environments post-pandemic. He has worked with administration to offer 7 fully online courses for fall 23, with more to follow in the spring, helping to broaden the BCC student demographic and geographic boundaries. The president has fostered invaluable relationships with our elected officials, both in the Bronx and beyond, helping to increase funding for infrastructure, programs, workforce and visibility for the institution that would not otherwise have been possible. He has opened the college to the community with esteemed visitors such as Governor Hochul, Mayor Adams, Senators Gillibrand and Sanders, as well as Senator Chuck Schumer, a frequent speaker at our commencement, and recipient of the Presidential Award, Attorney General Letitia James. Well, there you go. One more. Perhaps the most important aspect of our president's tenure here is his dedication, concern, care, communication, and support for our students. From the first day of classes every semester, President Sekinegbi can be seen welcoming students at the front gate. His time, effort, and commitment to our students' success extend beyond the first day of each semester and beyond the gates of this institution. It has been his number one priority every single day of his 8+ years as our president. Mr. President, our students thank you, and our faculty, staff, and administration thank you. It has truly been a privilege to serve under your leadership. You will be missed and remembered. It is now my pleasure to present the president, Bronx Community College, Dr. Thomas Sekinegbi.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
I want to say, Dr. Lopez, I want to say thank you for serving as a Master's of Ceremony this morning. Actually, we called on him at the last minute to do this, and you're doing a great job. Can we give him a round of applause? You know, I want to say thank you for those kind words, and it's been a pleasure here for the last 8 years. I am truly gonna miss this place. A boy from his little village in southern Nigeria. Somebody told me my wildest dream that I would be a president in CUNY school. I would tell them the line, but dreams do come true. So I want to say thank you to all of you, and thank you. It's been a wonderful ride, and thank you, everybody. Manny knows that I told him I don't say anything about me in my own humble way, because this is not about Thomas. This is about you, all of our students. So I just want to say what an honor for me to welcome all of you to our 63rd commencement today at Bronx Community College. Really, when I say it's an honor, it's truly an honor, because when we wake up every day, we come in here to do the work we do for our students. So it's truly an honor here. And today is really a momentous day as we come together to celebrate the outstanding achievement of our students. And I think really, when I see the students here, I see what I look like way years back, because I was the first in my family to go to college. And you know, graduate with your families by your side, you've accomplished something truly remarkable. And each of you need to be incredibly proud. Please give yourself a round of applause. Graduates, I also know you didn't do this on your own. If you say you did, that you'd be lying. If you did this with the help of your family, your friends, the faculty and the staff, and everyone who's giving you support along this route, can you please give a round of applause to you? Are you ready for your diploma?
Yeah.
Are you sure? But before you do, I just want to give a heartfelt congratulations to the faculty and staff that have really helped you throughout this journey. Can you please join me in saying thank you and giving the faculty a round of applause? Since you're saying thank you and your appreciation to the faculty, I think this is an ideal time for me to recognize five individuals that have gone beyond their ways this academic year to really help you succeed. We have what we call the President's Award of Excellence, and really what this was put in place, in fact, this was advocated for by the faculty to really acknowledge faculty and staff that have gone beyond their way to really help you students. This year, we have five individuals, as the name indicates, Excellency Award. These awards are to acknowledge the support of caliber work and dedication to the college. I want to extend my gratitude to the amazing faculty and staff who worked tirelessly to provide you with support and guidance along the way. This year, we wanted to thank most of those dedicated faculty and staff with the inaugural President's Award for Excellency in Teaching, Research, and Service. Can you please hold your applause until I've read all of the five names? And awardees, as I call your name, can you please stand? The President's Award for Teaching, full-time, Dr. Monique A. Gouchard, Associate Professor of Social Science. The President's Award for Excellency in Teaching, Adjunct Faculty, Dr. Amy Van Natter, Adjunct Professor of History. The President's Award for Excellence in Research, Dr. Eugene Mananga, Associate Professor of Engineering, Physics, and Technology. The President's Award for Excellence in Service, Ms. Tiffany Dubon Yard. And finally, the President's Award for Continuous Meritorious Service to our institution, Mr. Anthony Colon. I know Anthony couldn't be with us here this morning. Anthony, we are praying for you, and we wish you speedy recovery. Again, at the heart of what you've done over the years is the faculty. I'm going to ask the faculty to please stand one more time. Faculty, can you please stand, and let's give you a round of applause. On behalf of all of the graduating students, thank you, thank you, thank you. I would also like to thank our elected officials and civic leaders and organizers from the Bronx, the City of New York, and the New York State. You are all staunch supporters of our mission and of higher education in our borough. My special thanks to the Attorney General. My special thanks also to our senator, is not here, but I know he's on his way. To our Senator, U.S. Senator Chuck Schumer, our Bronx Borough President, Thank you so much for your friendship. Assemblywoman Yildeka Teapia and our City Councilwoman Perina Sanchez. You know, it's very important we say thank you to them because we can't do the work that we do without their support. So all of our elected officials, thank you very, very much. I know most of you, when we said, are you coming to commencement, your initial response was no. But when we told you who the commencement speaker is, most of you changed your mind quickly and said, whoops, I'm coming. So I want to give a special mention to our Attorney General, Letitia James, who is the New York State Attorney General. You're going to be hearing from her later, but I'm going to hold that person. But I also want to say thank you so much for coming this morning. Thank you very much. You know, we come to work every day and we do the things that we do, but most of us go back home and we complain about what's going on campus and all the things. So this is my last commencement, Cecilia. I want to say thank you to my family, Pat. I want to say thank you so much for everything and no more complaints after today. But Cecilia, I want to say thank you for your love and your support. To the graduates, each and every one of you have your own unique story and journey to share. Some of you are first-generation college students, while others have work, family obligations, and you've balanced them very well to bring you to this end point. Regardless of how you got here today, you have all shown tremendous perseverance, and that's something that needs to be celebrated. I just need the audience to know a little tidbit about the class of 2023. The class of 2023, we call them Broncos, and we have about 1,123 students graduating today. The youngest graduate is Geraldine Friars, who is 18 years old. And the oldest graduate is Wanda Alvarez, who is 64 years old. You know what? They both remind us that it's never too early or too late to fulfill a dream and succeed. Can we give both students a round of applause? Serving our country is a very noble deed. At this commencement, we have veteran students that are still serving or those that have already served. You bring your discipline and sense of duty to our campus as you safeguard our country's cherished memory. I would like for all of our veterans to please stand, and we want to say thank you for your service. Can veterans please all stand? We truly appreciate you and thank you so much for your service. You know, one of the things that brought me to Bronx 8 years ago was the richness and diversity of our community. If you look at our graduates, we have graduates from 47 countries, which is some campuses, my brother, really, the flags you see outside there really demonstrate the country or illustrate the countries our students are from. Today's graduates include our valedictorian, Elizabeth Asemuta from Nigeria, Ruby Laranca, who is a native of Dominican Republic. So it doesn't matter where you come from. In the Bronx, we take you. And that's the most important thing here, because that's what I like about the Bronx. We are a rich and diverse community. Ruby and Elizabeth are exemplary students. They both graduating with 4.00, and that's... And you know what? They're both recipients of the Jack Kenkut Transfer Scholarship, which provides about $55,000 in scholarship for the next 4 years at an institution. Again, one of the things we try to do here is to provide tools for our students to become successful. And one of those tools is the accelerated study in the associate program, better known as ASAP. This is an initiative that provides our students with tuition waiver, dedicated advisors, textbook vouchers, MetroCard, and above all, ensure that as many students as possible receive degrees in a timely manner. About half of our students are now enrolled in the ASAP program. The class of 2023 includes 646 members of the ASAP program. CUNY has recognized the achievement of ASAP at BCC and is being replicated across the country. It will one of the best measures of the ASAP program is graduation. Can we please ask all of the ASAP students to please stand? Thank you, graduates, and congratulations. I would also like, finally, to acknowledge the achievement of our sport teams. BCC students graduate 2.5 times the rate of our regular students. Our baseball team this year qualified for the CUNAC Championship for the fourth successive year in a row. Steve Correa, part of that team, was named to CUNY All-Stars, while Yunel De Rosa and Rocas were selected as members of the sportsman team. Men's soccer player Lores Averett, named also a member of the CUNY All-Stars, and his brother was also honored as a conference sportsmanship. Can we please ask all of our student athletes to please stand and let's acknowledge you. Thank you. Graduates, as I look into the audience, you are the portraits of our nation's future, no matter what other people will tell you. I know that when you leave here, you're going to go on to make a difference, not just in the Bronx, not just in the city, not just in the state, but in the entire world. Remember, wherever you go, BCC will always be your home, and we look forward to seeing all that you will achieve and make to the improvement of the world. Can you please join me one time in saying congratulations to our graduating class of 2023. It's my distinguished pleasure and honor at this time to introduce one of our trustees. The trustees are the men and women that truly volunteer their time to manage the affairs of CUNY. We are so fortunate to have with us this morning our own Bronx 11th Borough President, former 11th Borough President, and who is our new trustee. He's the chairman of the Fiscal Affairs Committee, and he's also the vice chair of the Governance Committee. Please join me giving a warm round of applause to Fernando Ferrer. Fernando will be bringing Fernando, you'll be bringing greetings from the board.
Thank you, President Sekenegbe. And good morning, BCC.
Morning.
Attorney General Tish James, the fearless Tish James. Borough President Gibson, Assembly Member Tapia, Council Member Sanchez, distinguished faculty, guests, families, friends, and most importantly, the reason we gather today, the class of 2023. On behalf of the Board of Trustees of City University, I'm honored to celebrate your academic success at this commencement. And we gather for this celebration at the highest elevation in the Bronx to recognize all that you bring to yourselves and have done to bring yourselves to this high point in your own lives. On this beautiful campus endowed with grand temples of learning, how can you not be inspired to learn, to excel, to imagine what more is to come for you? For many in the class of 2023, you are like me, the very first in your families to see the inside of a college campus, much less earn a degree from one. Or the parent of children who you helped earn a degree and decide once and for all that now was your time to achieve. But for whatever the reason, you are here now, and that's what counts. And while we're here, let's offer another round of applause to a great CUNY president, President Thomas Sekonegbe, for his years of service to Bronx Community College. Not only to the college, but all of its graduates over the years. I know you'll join me once again in wishing him well in the next chapter in his life. This is also a moment to reflect on your own journeys. You have come from all parts of the city and more than a few countries around the world. You and your families had to struggle just to keep up with the bills. Nothing was easy or handed to you, but now you have a new way of looking at the world and yourselves. From the first day this guy from Hunts Point came to this campus over 50 years ago, as a student when New York University used to live in this good neighborhood, I knew my life would never be the same. I came here to learn. In 1968, to start my own journey in a life of service that would lead to working for the city and state, being elected to represent this community in the New York City Council, later as borough president of the Bronx and now a trustee of City University. I know that your own journeys, your own learning, and this very special place have inspired you in the very same ways. So I'm not asking you to pay this wonderful opportunity back. You've already done that by successfully completing your academic work. On the contrary, I'm asking you to recognize that none of us got here alone. None of us. People who had faith in us, as well as people who had never met us before, stepped up to make these opportunities for us. Now our commitment must be to pay it forward, empowering yet another generation to be inspired, to learn, to dream, and to make a difference. That's the debt you owe, and that's the debt that I still happily pay after 51 years standing here and receiving my own diploma. Class of 2023, be very proud of yourselves because of your hard work and commitment. Today you receive a CUNY degree and an invitation to service. But don't look at today as the finish line, but the start of the next chapter in your own lives. So be bold and dream big. Make the world better for the next generation of New York. And good luck, class of 2023. God bless you.
Thank you kindly. That was wonderful. Trustee Ferrer. I'm just looking around to make sure I have the people who need to be here. Hey. That's right. I'm just looking for greetings from Senator Schumer, who's not here. So I'm going to ask our wonderful good friend of the Bronx, our Bronx Borough President, Vanessa Gibson, to please bring remarks.
Good morning, everyone. Buenos dias a todos. Bienvenidos. I am so excited to be here with all of you, the distinguished class of 2023 at BCC. To our CUNY Chancellor, Dr. Felix Matos Rodriguez, to our esteemed trustee, the 11th Bronx Borough President, Fernando Ferrer, to our president of BCC, Dr. Thomas Sekonegbe, to our US Senator, Charles Schumer, to our very own New York State Attorney General, Letitia James, to my colleagues in government, Assemblymember Yudelka Tapia and Councilmember Fiorina Sanchez. To our distinguished leaders, let me recognize our very own valedictorian Elizabeth Asamota, going to the University at Buffalo. Our salutatorian Ruby Larenquent, going to Princeton University. And our Student Government Association president, Sierra Moncayo, going to John Jay College. To each and every one of you, the graduating class of 2023, to our distinguished faculty, administrators, professors, everyone that is here in the BCC family, we thank you. Today represents a culmination of your hard work, of your commitment, your consistency, your dedication, your exceptional work, your hard work, your resilience, your strength in never giving up. You have made it this far, and today we celebrate. We celebrate your accomplishments and all that you have done to see this day. We know, graduates, that this journey was not easy. Like you, I am the first in my family to also graduate from college. I am what we call a twofer. I got my bachelor's degree at the University at Albany and my master's degree from Baruch College. SUNY and CUNY all the way. And we say that because we all have stories to tell. But we want to make sure that you can look at all of us on this stage and see yourself, see your hopes, your aspirations, and all of your dreams. As the 14th Bronx Borough President and the first African American and female to serve in this role, I am here as a living testament to tell you to never give up. Some folks will count you out, but guess what? God will always count you in. Never give up. There were folks that didn't think that I could see the victory line, that I could make history as a first. But I will tell you, shattering the glass ceiling is the greatest honor and privilege, but you know what's even better? While I am the first, I will not be the last. This work, graduates, is about making sure that we see you, leaders, in all spaces. Your ambition, your drive, your dedication speaks volumes to why we are here today. Never lose sight of this moment. This is historic, and it's a milestone. You have endured so much to see this day, and I want you to be proud of how far you have come. You have earned this moment, and don't let anyone take it away. Anyone. We are here to remind all of you that hard work will always pay off. You represent BCC. You represent the boogie down Bronx, through and through. And I want all of you to know, as the next generation of leaders, your block will never block your blessing, and your zip code will never deny your destiny. You have to be built for this moment, for this time, for this reason, and this season, and never give up. The faculty here at BCC have invested in all of you to prepare you for your next journey. We have planted the seeds and sowed into all of you because we believe in you. We know that you are the hope that we have for a better future. You are our beacon for a better community here in the Bronx. We need your leadership, graduates. We need your energy. We need your creativity. And we need your ideas. Because at the end of the day, we are sick and tired in the Bronx of being first in everything bad and last in everything good. But no more. I got good news for all of you. We are turning around that narrative, and we are turning statistics into success stories. Stand in your purpose. Make sure that you have a plan and you execute that plan. And most importantly, don't let someone stand on the sidelines and determine your future and your value and your worth. Some of us young folks, we got names for those people. Sometimes we call them haters. But guess what? Make your haters your motivators. Show them better than you can tell them. As an elected official, I love BCC. I have invested millions of dollars in this campus, from the Roscoe Brown Center to Gould Memorial Library to the North Instructional Library to the Daycare Center to supporting CUNY ASAP to making sure that BCC has everything that you need. Elected officials, we don't just talk the talk, but we walk the walk. So as you continue on your path to college and careers, we just want you to know how proud we are of you. Stand in this moment and stand in your purpose. You have earned your right to be here, and don't let anyone ever, ever dim your light. You are the stars that we need in this society today. And so as I close, I want to acknowledge the incredible leadership of our president, our very own Dr. Thomas Sekonegbe. For the past 8 years, he has served with honor and distinction as our president. And you know he is also a first. In the history of CUNY, we have never had a president representing the African diaspora from Nigeria. And we celebrate our heritage. We celebrate our diversity. And so as the Bronx Borough President, I have the honor and privilege of celebrating our very own president as he leaves us and opens a new chapter of service. After 8 years serving as our president, we are so proud, so grateful, so honored, and so blessed with his leadership. And so as the Bronx Borough President, I hereby declare today, Friday, June 2nd, 2023, as Dr. Thomas A. Sekonegbe Day in the Borough of the Bronx. These are just the privileges you get as Bronx Borough President. And in addition, I have a plaque that I want to present to our president, because I just want him to know that he is truly loved by all of us. And so as Bronx Borough President Vanessa L. Gibson, I honor Dr. Thomas A. Sekonegbe for your tireless commitment, innovative leadership, and exceptional service as president of BCC. Your extraordinary efforts have not gone unnoticed and unrecognized, and we believe it is essential to recognize and honor your service and the immeasurable difference that you have made here at Bronx Community College. We love you, and may God continue to bless you. Congratulations, graduating class of 2023.
Hold on a second. I didn't know we were testifying up in here. Yes, give it up one more time for our Bronx Borough President. Congratulations, President Sekonegbe. We're going to keep this moving right along, and we're going to ask New York State Assembly Member Yudelka Tapia to please come give greetings. Welcome. Thank you.
Thank you, thank you. Who are we?
BCC.
Who are we?
BCC.
And so happy to be here. And good morning, everyone. My name is Yudelka Tapia, and I'm an assembly member, and I'm your assembly member. If you live and you come to this university, if you come to BCC, I am your assembly member. Welcome to the class of 2023. Let's begin with giving yourself a big round of applause and letting yourself feel is because you made it this far. Most of all, I want to thank our parents and grandparents for their sacrifices to make sure that all of you graduate today. And for the devotion to caring for our kids, for all of you, our administrators, our CUNY staff, our faculty, our college personnel, and your friends, because they've been with you all the way in this journey. As I look out into this crowd today, I am seeing the future. The next generation of tech, healthcare, law, finance, and other, many other diverse industries that you are going to go into. In each of your faces, I see the progress of humanity. Youth was once linked with inexperience, but that is no more the case. Young people from all over the world make advances and breakthroughs daily in fields that reinvent what is possible and prepare us for any challenges that may arise. We have confidence in you guys for the future. The current state of the world will not wait. Your journey of restoring the world starts with you. Start now. It might be premature for you to begin considering the ways you would like to improve the world. And if you have been thinking about it already, your ideas might change. Keep calm though. Change can be positive, and the majority of the time is positive. Your dedication to success, your commitment to the community you live in, and your passion for development are constant. Growing up in today's culture is complicated. I know as a parent, and I know that many of the parents that are here know that it's complicated. As many of you can attest to firsthand as a parent, every day I learn new things regarding concepts like development of virtual reality and cryptocurrency, a big word. My duty, you, but I assure you, I'm making an effort to keep up with all these new challenges that we have. But in all honesty, my duty is different from yours. As a U.S. Assembly member, I have the honor of being tasked with building an environment in which you can always thrive and prosper. My goal is to support you and watch you rise above your fears, doubts, and let no worries stop any of you from achieving your goals. This commencement is proof that you have not only all built a strong foundation as scholars, but your commitment to pursuing higher education is a tribute of academic excellence. You have more information readily accessible to you than I or any of your parents ever had at your age. The obligation that comes with this great responsibility is significant. But I can promise you that I will keep fighting to deliver to you the tools you need to be fearless, courageous, and the most exceptional informing our collective destiny as part of the great of this great borough, our boogie down Bronx, and the Empire State. But before I close, I want to thank all of you that are here today celebrating the new steps. I want to thank our Attorney General that's here with us today, my hero, one of my heroes. I want to thank our Borough President who has been doing a tremendous, amazing job for this borough and for CUNY, as we all been fighting for. All our faculty that has been actually working with you for you to be able to be here. I want to thank my council member, Purina Sanchez, that is here. But lastly, but not least, I want to thank the president, your president, my president of this institution that for 8 years had led us with pride, had led us with good hard work to be able to put us where we are today. I wish you the best, Dr. Sekeneve, in your new endeavors, whatever it is, I know that you're gonna do good because you have done good all along. So, congratulations to the class of 2023. You have the world on your shoulders, and it's now up to you to save all of us, guys. Who are we?
BCC.
Who are we?
BCC.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you so much, New York State Assemblymember Yudelka Tapia. Thank you. Moving along, I'm going to ask our New York City Council member, Pirina Sanchez, to join us at the lectern. Welcome, Ms. Sanchez.
I just want to start. I want to be like, hey. So proud of you all, so proud to be here standing with you. My name is Pierina Sanchez, and I'm your city council member, which means I represent 170,000 people in the Bronx. Wow. And I would have never thought that when I was in high school, and I was attending the Bronx Community College Upward Bound Trio Program at Gould Residence Hall. How many of y'all had classes at Gould? Right? And so I'm just here to congratulate you, to join our elected officials, President Sekenegbe. Man, we are going to miss you. I was so sad when I got that call, but it's like our assembly member said, we know that only the best is ahead for you. Thank you so much for your service. So I'm Pierina Sanchez. I'm also the daughter of immigrants from the Dominican Republic. We outside, y'all. Right. My grandfather was a street vendor. He sold oranges on the street corner of Washington Heights well into when he was 90 years old. And my father sold peanuts in the streets of Santo Domingo with no shoes on. And a generation later, his daughter would come to BCC while she was in high school, would graduate from here, go on to Harvard University, Princeton University. Work in the White House, attend board meetings in the tallest buildings of Manhattan, being the only person that looked like I did with my hair as crunchy as it is. And so I'm here to say, y'all, there is not a room you don't belong in. There is not a ceiling that you won't break as long as you put your best foot forward, which we already know you know how to do because you're here today. And take heart in this. Bronx Community College, CUNY, is an engine of economic opportunity. In all of the United States, BCC ranks in the top 10 community colleges that moves our students from low-income, humble backgrounds like I came from and many of you come from into the middle class and beyond. Y'all gonna do it. So whenever you're doubting yourself, as you walk into a new job, as you go into a senior college, as you pursue whatever endeavor you are hoping to achieve, just remember your journey at BCC. Remember the long hours that you spent studying. Remember yourself pinching your eyelids, wanting to punch yourself a little bit so you could stay awake in your classroom. Because you were working the day before. Because maybe, like this mother who is standing and holding her baby in the back right now. Maybe that baby was keeping you up at 2, 3, 4, let's be real, y'all, 5 o'clock in the morning. You have been through so much to get here. And not only you, but your ancestors, your parents, and the struggles that they went through to get to New York City, whether they came from the South, whether they came from a different country, we're here, and we ain't going nowhere but up. So, I'll close with this. Is BCC in the house? Yeah. I don't know. Is BCC in the house? Yeah. Is the class of 2023, is BCC in the house? Congratulations.
All right, thank you, Councilmember Sanchez. As she said, we ain't going nowhere, and someone who's definitely not going anywhere and is here today is our wonderful Senator Schumer. Give it up for our Senator Schumer. Let's go. Thank you.
Thank you to this great class of 2023. BCC, congratulations. You've made it. You've made it. And I want to thank President Senkenebi. I want to thank all the faculty and staff, workers, all the way down to those who clean the floors late at night, making this one of the best community colleges, not only in New York City, not only in New York State, but in the USA. And you're going to hear from a great speaker, your honoree today, Tish James, who's done a great job for New York. Now, first, I'd like to say a word to the parents. I know how you feel. A few short years ago, my wife Iris and I sat where you did and watched our daughter Allison come up on the stage and get her diploma. It was one of the proudest days of our lives. Now, you've been through a lot as parents. It's not easy raising kids these days. But now, you get to watch all your blood, sweat, and tears pay off as your daughter or son walks on the stage, gets the diploma, and becomes an adult before your very eyes. Let's hear it for the moms and dads. And another word of thanks. As we're having a great time here today, there are many young men and young women, many from this community, who are in our armed forces, overseas, in dangerous places, risking their lives for us. Let's have a round of applause for them as well. Now, to this great class of 2023. Now, the challenges of the last few years have truly been unique. I'm sure you expected your time in college to bring new experiences, but that didn't include a global pandemic. And yet here you are, after having earned a degree from a truly fine institution of higher learning. You overcame immense obstacles to get here, as the last speaker mentioned. Nobody and nothing can ever take that away from you. It's yours. Now, we've got a lot of work to do, but little by little, life's returning to normal. It took a lot of work to reach this point. As Senate Majority Leader, the first ever from New York, I worked hard to pass the American Rescue Plan 2 years ago, which put money in the pockets of working families and small businesses, millions of dollars into this community from people who were hurt by the pandemic. And in the COVID relief bills, I was proud to bring $69 million to Bronx Community College, much of which went to help you get through COVID. And one more thing I'm working on, graduates. I'm working to get the president, the Congress, and the courts to get rid of that damn student debt that is on the shoulders of so many. We'll keep fighting till we win. So, graduates, to this great class, as you know, this is an era of profound economic and social change. In the old days, when you got out of college, the odds were you'd be in the same job, maybe even the same career for 40 years. That's not so true anymore. Most of you will have several jobs, and some of you will have several careers. And along with these economic changes, the internet has put so much information at our fingertips that sometimes it's really hard to tell what's true and what's not. All too often, the loudest voices get the most attention on the social media. But class of 2023, the good news about your changing world is this. Your generation is better equipped than any other that came before it to adapt to these changes, to overcome the obstacles they present and seize the opportunities they afford. But right now, sitting in your seats, you may not be sure of what's coming next. With so much of the world changing so rapidly around you, sometimes it feels like you're jumping into an abyss. But graduates, the key is not to fear the unknown. Embrace it. Relish it. Soak up every possibility it has to offer. Cast aside your fears and doubts. So my advice to the class of 2023 is simple. Go for it. Now, how do I know? How do I know? I remember feeling doubts when I was your age. When I was seated at college graduation years back, I had just learned that I had won a scholarship to travel all around the world, all expenses paid, for a whole year. For me, it was the opportunity of a lifetime. My family didn't have much money. I had never been out of the country before. But even though I had this opportunity of a lifetime, at the same time, I met a girl and I fell in love. Aww. So graduates, I had to decide. Do I go around the world on the all-expense-paid scholarship for a whole year? Or do I stay home with the girl, my first true love? Class of 2023, what would you have done? Mr. President, the class is divided. I stayed home with the girl. Don't clap yet, you romantics. The story continues. That summer, she went on a brief vacation, and I went to the airport to meet her on her return. As soon as she got off the plane, I saw by the look on her face, something was the matter. She dumped me by Labor Day. There I was, no scholarship, no trip around the world, no girl. I said to myself, what a loser you are. You're never gonna make anything of yourself. And in fact, I stayed in my house for several months, moped around, feeling bad for myself, but somehow I picked myself up, dusted myself off, and moved forward. And found myself seated a few years later, found myself seated at graduation once again. But on the way, this time from law school. But on the way home from graduation, I broke the news to Mom and Dad that I wasn't going to join the fancy law firm like we had planned. I told them politics was my passion. My dream was to run for public office. My parents were shocked. My mother was particularly disappointed. You see, I grew up in a working-class family. My dad was an exterminator in Brooklyn. We never had much money. And the law firm was paying $400 a week, which in those days was more money than my family had ever seen. But my heart wasn't in it. I didn't want to sit there. I didn't like that job at the law firm. I was pushing a pencil for some rich guy who I never met, and I thought if I met him, I'd never like him. So my passion was public service. My dream, run for public office, make the world a better place. And so that fall, at the age of 23, against very long odds, I ran for the New York State Assembly, and I had three opponents. There was the party machine candidate, there was a neighborhood activist, and then there was my mother, who was telling all her friends not to vote for me. So as she said, I'd get this dumb idea of being a politician out of my big, thick head. Well, graduates, a few years earlier, I sure didn't get that girl. But that November, I won the election. So to this great class of 2023 BCCC, my advice, take the risk. Don't let the fear of failing deter you. For those of us who have gotten older and look back on life, one of the more painful moments is what I call the what-ifs. What if I'd only done this? What if I'd only gone there? My advice to the class of 2023 is simple. Go for it. You're about to cast into the unknown. I know that can seem scary, but you've got great assets. A great education from Bronx Community College. Families that'll have your backs through thick and through thin. So graduates, garner up your courage. Garner up your strength. Put aside your doubts. Take a chance. And if you do, it is my hope, it is my prayer, and indeed it is my confidence that you will find true success and true joy in life. To this great class of 2023, congratulations. Good luck. Godspeed. And don't forget, go for it.
Thank you, Mr. President. Whatever I can do for the college, thank you.
So what does the senator want you to do? Go for it. Thank you so much, Senator Schumer. I want to thank one more time all of our elected officials here today, the senator, our Bronx Borough president, Vanessa Gibson, our New York State Assembly member, Yudelka Tapia, and our New York City Council member, Pirena Sanchez. Thank you all very much. Now, the next person who I'm going to bring up is actually a Bronx Community College alum. He's also a faculty at the college. So you're going to hear from a faculty who's graduated from Bronx Community College. The chair of the faculty senate, Professor Ronnie Benoon, please join us to bring greetings.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm not gonna bother with the hat. I think it disturbs my hairdo, so I'm gonna just keep it off. Well, bienvenidos a todos. Welcome to Bronx Community College. Distinguished guests, elected officials, administration, faculty, families, and of course, most important, our wonderful students. This is all for you. You know, I want to thank everyone for coming today and sharing this celebration that is commencement. I'm Professor Ronnie Benoon, chair of the BCC College Senate, and it is my duty and privilege to bring you greetings on behalf of the faculty and staff here. I too went to school here. I don't know, it's 26 years ago, I think. It's a long time ago. I had more hair, believe me. You know, for me, it's a very personal thing to be here and talk to you, being that, you know, I sat where you sat. And I'm thinking of all our elected officials who spoke about their, you know, their journey. And I hope that you are inspired by this, because when I was where you are, I didn't know what's going to happen. I didn't know what I'll become. I didn't even know if I'll succeed. I came here as a foreign student. You know, I worked in moving company to pay the bills. It was like, you know, the struggle is real. It's not a joke. Look at me now. You know, I became a full-time faculty here. chair of my department, of the art and music department, and then the highest elected faculty position here, the BCC Senate. I'm very proud of my achievements, and I am especially happy that it happened here in my college where I first, you know, went to school. And I hope that for many of you it'll be the same. There are a lot of people here that work and teach here that went to school here. There's actually more than 200 of us alums. You know, this place is special, and apparently special enough to have so many of us come back. I want to say this to you guys. You know, whether you continue on to four-year school, you know, a lot of you will transfer and get that bachelor's. Maybe some of you start a career now that you got your associates. Maybe some of you want to just take a break. You know, it doesn't really matter what your plans are, or even if you have a plan, because sometimes, you know, you don't have a plan yet. I just want to remind you something in this crazy world of ours, that to be successful doesn't have to be like, you know, about money, about fame. You know, there's a lot of that always going around. You don't have to be some fancy influencer or some billionaire to be successful. I mean, I consider myself successful, and I'm sure that all these wonderful women elected officials who spoke before me consider themselves very successful compared to where you started and where we are today. Success does not have to be measured in, you know, in money or fame. It has to be measured in the heart. How much you manage to progress your life and how much really you do good for other people. Yes, thank you. Yep. At the end of the day, you know, it's really, you know, what is the point, you know, of your life? What are you going to do? It doesn't matter if you become a lawyer or a plumber. I don't really care. I don't think it matters at all. And believe me, I don't think God cares. What I care about, and I think what most of us care about, is people, you know, the people around you, your families, your loved ones, your friends. You know, I'm hoping that, like for myself and for other people that you heard from, this opportunity that you got here is the beginning of making your life a better life in that sense, in the sense of making good, you know, bringing goodness to the world. You know, the more successful you are career-wise, education-wise, financially, you know what? It just gives you more opportunity to do good for other people. So I hope you remember that lesson, and I hope you apply it to your life. Be proud of your achievement. You know, it's a really big deal. Don't listen to haters. Oh, it's a two-year college, it's an associate degree. I don't care. It's a big deal. It took you a lot of work to get here, so yeah. Yes, appreciate what you achieved, because this is a big achievement. It is, and you should be proud, and we, as we are, proud of you. I'll tell you, you know, I hope that you'll remember BCC well. I hope we treated you well. You know, in general, I'm hoping that we do. I just want to say that if you take one thing from here, think about the community that we are. You know, I think other than our esteemed borough president and maybe the senator, everyone else like me has an accent because we are from different backgrounds. If you look around you, you see this wonderful diversity that we are, and remember that and take it with you wherever you go. You know, as you break barriers, as these ladies broke their barriers, help others along. You know, remember those behind you. If you break a barrier, then help the other ones through. You know, there's a lot of hate and there's a lot of unfairness in this world, but You can make your world better by, you know, loving one another and treating others as you would want to be treated. As you look towards your future, I want to leave you with some words of scripture. This is from Jeremiah 29, verse 11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. So now go out into the world and spread love and goodness. Congratulations. BCC.
Thank you so much, Professor Benoon. All righty. The Student Government Association is a representative body of this student body here. And the president, as you may know, is Sierra Moncayo. And I'm going to ask now Sierra to come give her greetings as the SGA president and
greetings. Hi, everyone. So first and foremost, I just want to say congratulations to all of us. Yeah. So as some of you guys may know, if you don't know, my name is Sierra Moncayo, and I'm the SGA president here at Bronx Community College. Now, if you know me and you heard any of our SGA senators walking around, what's one thing we always say? And I'm going to need my SGA to back me up on this. Can I get an AO? Yeah, no, I need the crowd to do it with me. One more time. Can I get an AF?
AF!
Yeah, thank you, thank you. Greetings again. So I am a second generation college student of Black and Ecuadorian descent. I was born and raised in the South Bronx. Yeah. My major is criminal justice with a concentration in forensic psychology. And as you may have heard, I am going to be going to John Jay College. Yeah. While my college journey has been a very long one, I have a strong feeling it's just getting started. I graduated high school in 2016, and I'm graduating BCC in 2003 at 25 years old. And thank you. It's been a very long journey, and I'm gonna tell you one thing. I've taken many a breaks, whether it's due to the pandemic, life, or just I didn't have the motivation. I'm not gonna lie to you, it's very hard to come back, but the fact that I came back and the fact that all of you guys, no matter if you took a break or you just went straight through, we came back and we finished this and we did what we had to do. And I'm so, so, so proud of all of us, each and every one of us. Even if I don't know you, if you don't know me, I'm so freaking proud of all of us, every single one of us. Because I know the deadline, 11:59, just give me a raise of hands. 11:59, yes, yes, we all felt that. I'm so proud of all of you guys. I do want to leave you guys with one thing before I give my little salutations. There's a lot of obstacles in this world, and the biggest question you can have is what if. You don't want to live life with what ifs. You want to live with if when, if anything. Because if when, you're not waxing what if. What if is, oh, what if I do this? If when, it's, oh, like, I'm going to do this, but, like, I'm going to give myself some time. I'm going to tell you guys a little bet I actually made with my advisor, Tiffany. She bet with me that if she gets her driver's license before me, then she's gonna take me out, right? That was our bet. Yeah, she's gonna take me out. And if she gets hers before me, she's gonna sit in the back of my road test like my mom and tell me, and make sure the instructor sees what I'm doing. So I'm gonna teach this as a lesson to all of you guys. She doesn't have her permit, I do. I can get it first, all right? I'm gonna win the bet, okay? I need you, all of you guys, to look at life not as a bet, but as like a good competition, you know? Like, don't knock people down that support you and help you. You gotta use them to push you forward, to thrust you forward. Use that support system. And I'm telling you, the friends you've made here are gonna follow you throughout life. I've made friends since the very first day I've gotten here, and I'm making friends today, and it's graduation day. Like, yeah. So before I leave, I do want to shout out all of my SGA, whether you're SGA alum or SGA currently. Can I have all my SGA please stand up? Yeah. Can I have a round of applause for our beautiful SGA, please? Well, I'm going to leave you guys with congratulations. Thank you.
Congratulations. I'm going to acknowledge a couple of more students before we keep moving forward. I would like to first recognize this year's salutatorian, Miss Ruby Lauren Kent. Please stand, Ruby. We're all proud of Ruby. You see the Dominican flag right there in the front. She is a, and her family's right. Where's Ruby's family? Come on, you can stand as well. That's all right. Ruby is a BCC Jack Kent Cook's transfer scholar, as was said earlier. Congratulations, Ruby. Thank you. Additionally, it's my pleasure to introduce the Bronx Community College 2023 valedictorian, Miss Elizabeth Acemota. You come on over. Miss Acemota is also a Jack Kent Cook Scholar. Yes, yes, and a graduate. So please offer some greetings to this student body.
Thank you, Dean Lopez. Greetings to President Isekenebe, Provost Andres Rapallo, distinguished faculty, the phenomenal class of 2023, elected officials, and our distinguished guests. I stand before you today as the valedictorian of this resilient class of 2023. I use the word resilient because every one of you graduates seated here today either began this journey here at BCC right before or during the peak of a pandemic, the most uncertain times of our lives. But we all made sure of one thing, to persevere until the end. Actually, sorry, not the end, but rather to persevere up until this moment. Also, take note that to commence, which is what we are celebrating today, means to begin and not to end. So while this commencement ceremony may have been put together to celebrate the end of our time here at BCC, it also marks the beginning of a new journey of our lives. Make sure to make it a good one. I want to also start by appreciating all who have made my time at BCC worthwhile. They have poured into me, showed up for me, and most importantly, believed in me even in times when I doubted myself. I want to use this medium to thank President Isekenebe. He's a representation for me as a Nigerian. I also want to thank the Dean, Dean Lopez, who's always one call away, ever ready to hype me up and help me. I also want to thank Mr. Marshall, who believed in me during my application process for the Jack and Cook Scholarship. He called me a winner even before I was actually declared a winner. I also want to thank Mama Erazo, which is not here with us anymore, and Miss Tiffany Dubon, for her guidance, advice, and a willingness to help all the time. To my professors, who I was blessed with to pour knowledge to me, I say thank you. Lastly, to the friends and community that I made throughout my journey, with a big shout out to the Student Government Association, ASAP, the Male Empowerment Network, and the BCC First Year Program, I say thank you. Now to my speech. If I was to title this speech, I would call it the gift that keeps on giving. And I will explain what that means to me in a little bit. And I hope that that serves as a source of inspiration and motivation to someone. To begin, I was not born in the United States. I'm a Nigerian immigrant, so while growing up, I did not envision my life to be anything like what it is now. However, my parents did give me the gift of education right from the start. Shout out to my dad, who cannot be here today, but I know he will be watching this. Today, I'm an academic weapon because of him. Because of that gift, I have the opportunity to stand here before you today as a recipient of the prestigious Jack and Cook Scholarship, a proud CUNY graduate, and a soon-to-be SUNY graduate, and by God willing, maybe one more graduate after that. Who knows? For my doctorate degree. And I want to quickly take this opportunity to one more time advocate for all CUNY students against the budget cuts being made to CUNY. All programs need necessary funding. Higher education is a gift that has given to me, and it should continue to give to others. Lastly, I will, for the next part of my speech, I'll be reading out a few statements, and if any of the statements apply to you, to the grads, I need you to please stand up. Please stand up if you're a first-generation college student and either had to help yourself or actively fight guidance throughout while obtaining your degree. Stay standing. If you held a leadership position as a student or you're a student athlete, please stand. Stay standing. Keep standing. If you had to walk while you were in college, please join them. Stand up, please. If you're a student parent, please stand. If you're a veteran, please stand. If you had to spend extra painful hours working on a project, an exam, please stand. And if you're a class of 2023 graduate, please stand. I see nobody sitting. I just want to give yourself a round of applause. Celebrate yourself one more time. And now you can please have your seat. Those are all reminders of your hard work, perseverance, and dedication that you put into this. And I hope that you take time to reflect on your progress today and celebrate yourselves even as you're being celebrated. Once again, congratulations to the class of 2023.
I know we're really running with time. Can we say one more time, thank you, Miss Elizabeth, and thank you to our valedictorian. I think most of you told me you come into commencement because we have a dynamic speaker, commencement speaker today with us. And in fact, Manny, that's the report you get to. Sure, yeah, and it's, picking her as our commencement speaker is something that, one of those spur of the moment decisions that I made. Madam Attorney General, you came to the CUNY luncheon in Albany to speak and to bring greetings. After listening to you, I said to Eddie, I said, I want her as our commencement speaker. After listening to you, I said, did you see the passion? So I want to say thank you for your service to our state and thank you for your service. Basically on behalf of all of us, of what you do for us. I had a long bio that I was going to read here. That's just one sentence. I just want to say, she is the 67th Attorney General of the State of New York. She was elected in 2018, and she became the first woman of color to hold an statewide office in New York, and the first woman to be elected Attorney General. Can we please give her There is a long bio that we have here. I'm not going to read it, but as from all of us from Bronx Community College, we just want to say thank you for your service, not just to our city, but to our state, but as a country, for your leadership role. This is the President Medal of Honor who presented this to the board. We want to say thank you. We can't wait to listen to you speak.
I appreciate you. Thank you. So I know I stand between you and your degrees, so I will be short. Yeah, we've heard a lot of speeches. And I know it's hot out there, and your parents are out there, and your loved ones are out there. So I'm gonna try to keep this real short and sweet and speak to all of you. Because like all of you, all of the elected officials who spoke, except for Senator Schumer, Assemblywoman Tapia, Council Member Sanchez, the Borough President Vanessa Gibson, and myself, we come from humble beginnings. All of us come from humble beginnings. All of us are first, and here we are. I am the 67th Attorney General, the first African-American woman ever elected statewide, and but I stand before you because I want all of you to know that nothing really special about me or any of the elected officials who came before you. There's nothing special about any of us. The reality is that we're here because of grit and determination. As the Attorney General of the State of New York, I thank you for all of your kind words and for having me here today. As the Attorney General, all of you are fearless because you have what I have in me. Yes, I am prosecuting individuals who are responsible for the opioid crisis. Yes, I'm going after the gun distributors who cause carnage and destruction in the Bronx and beyond. Yes, I'm going after all of those individuals who unfortunately operate nursing homes that hurt senior citizens. Yes. Yes, I'm also going after the former president. So if I can do it, and I apologize, I'm not from the Bronx, I'm from Brooklyn. Ah, Brooklyn's in the house. If I can do it, all of you can do it. The power, my friends, is in your hands. So I want to thank all of the individuals who were on the dais. I'm not going to mention all of them because we've already mentioned them. I thank each and every one of them. I want to thank the professors who helped mold your minds, and to the parents who sacrificed and paid your tuition, to your family members and your aunts and your uncles, your sisters, your brothers, your friends and loved ones who traveled near and wide. Today could not have happened without them. And of course, the graduates, you started from the bottom like me, but we are here. So it is truly an honor to be selected to share some thoughts with this class of smart, ambitious young people. Today is a huge achievement, one that you will remember for the rest of your lives. You had your moments of self-doubt. There were days of loneliness. There were days and nights when you wanted to quit, days when you thought that you couldn't do all the work or couldn't balance the time with your other commitments. You didn't have the money. There were childcare issues, there were work issues, family issues, relationship issues. You lost some people in your family. But despite all the odds, here you are. Despite all the odds against you. And let me just say, there's a lot of individuals here, and there were people who didn't believe in your dream. In fact, there might be some people here who are applauding you today, who didn't believe in your dreams. Don't look at them, look at me. They're here now, but they weren't here then. But that's okay. We're not gonna look at them, we're gonna look forward. It's because that was yesterday, and today is the only day that matters. You dreamt about today. You sacrificed for today. You worked your tail off today. You stayed at the library late, and you even prayed for today, and it's finally here, so congratulations. As the 63rd graduating class of BCC, you have the distinction of graduating from one of the most diverse educational institutions in the state of New York. More than 200 different languages are spoken on this campus, and are represented at today's ceremony by 200 flags that surround us. Here in New York, we embrace and celebrate diversity. There are no haters here. We recognize it as our strength, as our superpower, a a key to a more stable and prosperous future for you as graduates and for us as a nation. Because soon, graduates, you will hold in your hand a symbol of power, a power that will transform your lives and the lives of so many others, power that can transform the world, that can change your story, that can elevate your existence and launch you into the next chapter. And we, as a city and state and nation, need your power now more than ever before. We need your power to turn this country around and make it the kind of country and nation that you deserve. We need your energy, your passion, your skills, your sense of purpose if we are ever to get back on the right track. We need bold leaders with iron constitutions, impeccable training, and the drive to continue moving us forward. Because the issues, my friends, are complex and long. Issues such as the right to vote, a woman's right to choose, housing issues, hate issues, issues involving immigrants and migrants coming to our country that we need to protect and support and stand with. Issues here in the Bronx and all throughout this city, poverty, gun violence, and all the issues that we care about, all of us, you have the power to stand with us to make a difference in the lives of those here in this borough, in this city, and in this nation. We will need your energy, we will need your passion, and your sense of purpose to confront the challenges we are facing in the boardrooms, the halls of government, the corporations or not-for-profit. And whether you transition to a four-year degree or out into the workforce, I have no doubt that your BCC education has prepared you to face the many challenges. You have already demonstrated your fearlessness. You know what success means to you. So while these are daunting times, they remain times full of possibilities. And please know that adversity has been the hallmark of many great leaders. Adversity is your strength, your power. Adversity obviously will propel you forward. Every defeat, every disappointment, every heartbreak, every loss, every setback is a setup for a comeback. And with your degrees, you can all make a difference in improving the city, country, and world. So my charge to you is simply continue to grow, continue to succeed, continue to learn because it's an ongoing learning experience. And most of all, continue to be the powerful people you have shown yourselves to be. You see, they underestimate you, but you continue to overperform over and over and over again. So when you walk into a room, you own it because you are graduates of BCC. And so I cut my speech in half, and that deserves a round of applause. Congratulations, graduates of 2023. We need you. We need you now. You crushed it. You made it, and you're here. Thank you.
Well, that was fun, right? Oh, my Lord. Yes, yes, yes. The only thing that remains undone is to lift both these mics. If I was Miss Attorney General James, I would have lifted both of these mics and dropped them both at the same time. But we're at commencement. Every setback is a setup for a comeback. I love that. Beautiful. Thank you kindly. So we are literally minutes away from your two things. One, we are going to ensure that our provost and our president confer your degrees. So to manage expectations, you are going to be called by your academic program, which is either Associate of Art, Associate of Science, Associate of Applied Science. If you forgot which one that is, look in the program. Look in the program and make sure that you know which. No, we're good. So, with that, I ask the provost to please join us. And provost, so right here.
We need to confer the degrees first for the year. We need to confer the degrees first for the year.
Right here?
Yep.
President Sekenegbe, on behalf of the faculty of the Bronx Community College, I have the honor of presenting the candidates for degrees for the classes for summer 2022, fall 2022, winter 2023, and spring 2023. With all the candidates for the Associate in Arts AA degree, stand and remain standing. President Sekenegbe, I present to you the candidates who have fulfilled all requirements for their Associate in Arts degree. I have the privilege of recommending that you confirm the degree upon them.
Thank you, Mr. Provost. By the power vested in me by the Board of Trustees of the City University of New York and by the Regents of the University of the State of New York, and upon the recommendations of the faculty of the college, I now confer upon each of you the degree for which you've been recommended, together with all of the rights and privileges and responsibilities dear to pertaining. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. President. With all the candidates for the Associate in Science degree, AA degree, stand and remain standing. President Sekenegbe, I present to you the candidates who have fulfilled all requirements for the Associate in Science degree. I have the privilege of recommending that you confirm the degree upon them.
Thank you, Mr. Provost. By the power vested in me by the Board of Trustees of the City University of New York and by the Regents of the University of the State of New York, and upon the recommendations of the faculty of the college, I now confer upon each of you the degree for which you've been recommended, together with all of the rights and privileges and responsibility thereto pertaining. Congratulations.
Congratulations. With the candidates for the Associate in Applied Science AAS degree and remain standing, President Sekenegbe, I present to you the candidates who have fulfilled all requirements for the Associate in Applied Science degree. I have the privilege of recommending that you confirm their degree upon them.
Thank you, Mr. Provost. By the power vested in me by the Board of Trustees of the City University of New York and by the Regents of the University of the State of New York, and upon the recommendations of the faculty of the college, I now confer upon each of you the degree for which you've been recommended, together with all of the rights and privileges and responsibility thereto pertaining. Congratulations.
With the candidates for the certificate, stand and remain standing. President Sekenegbe, I present to you the candidates who have fulfilled all requirements for their certificates. I have the privilege to recommend that you confirm the degree upon them.
Thank you, Mr. Provost. By the power vested in me by the Board of Trustees of the City University of New York and by the Regents of the University of the State of New York, and upon the recommendation of the faculty of the college, I now confer upon each of you the certificate for which you've been recommended, together with all of the rights and privileges and responsibilities thereto pertaining. Congratulations. Graduates, are you ready? Let's go, Mr. Manny.
Angelo Baez.
Jovan Campbell.
Laisha Gonzalez.
Lunique Agostini.
Najee Barnes Lassiter.
Carlos Vega.
Lenin Jacob.
Malaysia Wesley.
Antonia Hyacinth.
Daisy Lucia Morris.
Julibet Valera.
Dariana Peña Rodriguez.
Karina Sanchez.
Nairobi Lopez. Marcos Abreu.
Carolyn Peña.
Jennifer Lopez. Jennifer Lopez.
Ayana Ruiz.
Andrew Polanco Tejada. Brandon Torres.
Sharina Johnson.
Jasmine Kemp.
Madeline Garcia.
Maria Isabel Sanchez.
Amatou Barry.
Scott Keith Harris.
Marielle Deschamps Laura.
Sabrina Santos.
Tiffany Lopez.
Ambimbola Amifonsen.
Saina Tesu.
Leanne Coleman.
Fiara Aaron.
Jada Adams Diamond.
Layla Kolinovic.
Karen Riera.
Elizabeth Sarita.
Ruby Larenquent.
Sierra Moncayo.
Alexis Cintron.
Nairobi Diaza.
Gabriel Batin.
Jose Picharo.
Johnny Frankie.
Mancy Meckel.
Angelica Herman.
Sarari Garcia. Sarai.
Michael Del Valle.
Andrea Roman.
Caber Alonso.
Jada Wilkerson.
Yeah, Jada!
Sergio Ruiz. Elvis Segura.
Jamie Sanchez.
Marie Esteves.
Tyree Rodriguez.
Eileen Suero.
Andrew Freeman.
Daife Felipe.
Alsani Sibene.
Keliani Garcia.
Saba Hussein.
Michael Big Mike Rodriguez.
Marlene Rivera.
Joanna Garnelo Sanchez.
Dominica Hilar.
Milady Diaz.
Jaylene Bravo.
Aida Blanco.
Denicia Carbon.
Amy Agosto.
Nicholas Hill.
Kadeja Stevenson.
Fatima Adoti.
Giselle Garcia Diaz.
Aisha Konate.
Anthony Clow.
Genesis Diaz.
Anabel Herrera.
Plaktiva Kasi.
Wilfrandi Arias.
Ariana Cardoza.
Shaquena Gregory.
Carlos Fresneda.
Najia Betis.
Anisha Ortega.
Kimberly Gomez.
Geraldine Vargas.
Sara Colon.
Jahira Rosario.
Celine Araujo Abreu.
George Mendez.
Stephanie Judith Paez.
Ivory Rivera.
Rebecca Rodriguez.
Alexis Powell.
Derek Santos.
Jonathan No.
Jules J.D. Castillo.
Ruby Mar Acevedo Martinez.
Chelsea Ureña.
Catherine Juveres.
Camila Garcia.
Manisha Daly.
Juan Aquino.
Maria Torres.
Marlene Nunez.
Arabel Morel.
Michael Rodriguez.
Neshali Perez.
Fidaus Abdul Fatah.
Rosy Camacho.
Jen Liam Vasquez.
Yolanda Flores Nunez.
Lisbeth Castillo.
Natasha Munoz Nedrado.
Bajan Ashcroft.
Eric Rivera.
Gabriel Ben-Cosme.
Natalie Galva Feliz.
Roy Hayes.
Ambar Naomi Fermin Abreu.
Alexis Amparo Martinez.
Marianne Rodriguez Robinson.
Kemali Abreu.
Yaricel Maria Alvarado.
Brandon Suarez.
Nicole Estrella Amarante.
Julie Beth Baez Cruz.
Jarrett Lee Robinson.
Edwina Rivera.
Gabrielle Zahuantitla.
Aliyah Maynard.
Gina Rosario.
Melissa Lopez.
Yospeini De Jesus.
Janelle Rosen.
Cristina Torres.
Mariama Jalo.
Danielis Rodriguez. Deanna Sanchez. Jatna Maciel Rodriguez Paulino.
Jacqueline Garcia.
Shania Taveras.
Jose Tejada Hidalgo.
Wilmer Galva.
Destiny Graham.
Maciel Marmolejos.
Yazbek Rosa.
Elizabeth De La Cruz.
Marlelis Hernandez.
Nicole James.
Gia Manasha Colston.
Janine Rodriguez.
Jamilet Mendoza Carrasco.
Danielle Watson.
Erifer Hernandez.
Janine Abonte.
Genesis Caraballo.
Giovanna Abreu.
Crisali Moya.
Mariorki Delgado de la Cruz.
Darla Corbua.
Shimona Moonsami.
Janae Bartley.
Ayman Aslaibi.
Eugenio Breton.
Emily Franco.
Khadija Palmer.
Jessica Crithola.
Nancy Benitez Salazar.
Maria Solis.
Angelica Del Villar.
Dominique Vittorio.
Sydney Hyatt.
Brahim Iyahi.
Cindy Toribio.
Malik Keita. Jocelyn Villamil.
Omar Pavich.
Annette Maria.
Catherine Jamali Herrera.
Catherine Alohipan.
Rosalie Pabon.
Karen Biggs Castro.
Cindy Medina.
Marcos Montesino.
Stephanie Sanchez.
Kiara Rodriguez Murga.
Valerie Rodriguez Murga.
Amy Baez Cordero.
Estefany Vargas.
Kair Brown.
Manuela de Jesus Nunez.
Nina Mejia.
Jason Gonzalo Lopez.
Melvin Almarenga Mejivar.
Ibrahim Giallo.
Marian Dominguez.
Juliana Gomez.
Rafael Florencio.
Kelvin Avila.
Jada Monroe.
Patrick Brown Jr.
Stacy Lorraine Whitehead.
Aisha Alkafi.
Zakaya Ransom.
Adeline Ramirez.
Natasha Mackenzie Nelson.
Madeline Margarine.
Caitlin Crandall.
Jennifer Vasquez.
Nival Unique Palmer.
Antoinette Jackson.
Catherine Acosta.
Amina Darden.
Elizabeth Casul.
Samson Oshode.
Argeni Perdomo.
Vanessa Nidia Hunter.
Angela Giselle Girardo.
DeAndre McKenzie.
Brianna Silverio.
Yafresi Nunez.
Gisairi Cabral.
Jacqueline Fortoso.
Carlos Sosa.
Ikimatu El Haji.
Yasmeri de la Cruz.
Reni Minaya.
Jay Aquino.
Carla Sanchez Medina.
Phoenix Santana.
Tiffany Colon.
Mariceles Cabral Batista.
Julia Monegro.
Makila Hopkins. Makayla.
Jariel Peguero.
Engelbert Cervantes.
Giovanni Rosario.
Tajana Lee.
Ashley De Leon.
Joanny Maldonado.
Marianela Trejo De Leon.
Alania Gomez.
Luis Roman Sanchez.
Carlos Galicia.
Brandel Jorge Carporan.
Christopher Messon.
Angel Calderon.
Alex Messon.
Angel Dionisio.
Jose Jimenez.
Rachel Montilla.
Sally Flores Zuniga.
Katie Kida.
Carlos Nieves Aristi. Mohammed Shabain.
Walter Fernandez.
Esmelina Cabreja.
Tanisha Williams.
Florence Mensa.
Carrie Sanchez.
Mariam Goris.
Toshi Hamilton.
Chanel West. Heidi Pena.
Crisper Enrique Quesada.
Sorry. Esther Samoa.
Mohamed Olamin Sila. Taisha Garcia Gill.
Buna Jeng.
Kalia Brown.
Hope Fonseca.
Dior Lamond.
Miriam Cintron.
Janet Pokua Orkran.
Cynthia Martins.
Richard Akrisi Kisi.
Ernestina Wiafe.
Kiera Frost. Alex Romero.
Denise Robinson.
Gayon Newsom. Christina Ortiz.
Ramos Almengo. Schneider Yeli.
Drevin Fontanes.
Naima French.
Noisvel Lopez.
Princess Miller. Emanuela Ado Doku.
Rafael Juliao.
Albert Swatson Annan.
George Dua Ampate.
Maxia Carbonell Suarez.
Lydia Yamoa.
Bernice Ajewa.
Francis Gonzalez.
Giovanni Torres.
Delany Mejias.
Matthew Black.
Cheyenne Brito.
Saeed Tanvir.
Harish Sanz.
Tu So.
Marianne Lugo.
Jose Soto.
Elijah Crespo.
Terrence Byram.
Danny Tello.
Darlene Allen.
Rafael Okran.
Kenneth Flowers.
Duquan London.
JT Jason Ofosu Mensa.
Charlotte Sharshar Lazama.
Ayana Cheranji Lal.
Troy Williams.
Ingrid Nival.
Jared Huesner.
Richmond Johnson.
McGlory Endogo.
Miguel Marrero.
Isalam Ahmed.
Josue Sergio Rosa Alvarez.
Osama Neji.
Clement Garimaldi Feliz.
Richard Duran. Delia Eleonora.
Emilia Agbenis. Jonathan Gray.
Maria Ruiz.
Kiara Natal.
Tanashi Joseph.
Brendan O'Brien.
Yedeni Diaz. Wadia Perkins.
Jeanette Welch.
Ana Rodriguez. Winifer Sanchez.
Kiara Isabel Abreu.
Makima Wallace.
Ibrahima Berry.
Yuri Xavier Batista.
Alex Shaha.
Francisco Cruz.
Ana Ortiz Raimundo.
Ayodel Ayoojo.
Joseph Adam.
Melissa Roman.
Yeah, Melissa!
Charlotte De Jesus.
April Q. Jones.
Kiara Fernandez. Margaret
O'Berry. Joanna Gonzalez de los Santos.
Mohammed Hazma.
Mamadou Wage.
Jazid Tonge.
Marialina Fabian Gonzalez.
Gregory Colon.
Aaliyah Johnson.
Jennifer Goldson.
Derek Davis.
Miriam Marrero.
Samantha Lagler.
Leilatu Doncor.
Charitza Santana Castillo. Nairobi Santos.
Unix Pena.
Dolores Soto.
Ulysses Estevas.
Thomas West.
Bernie Urania.
Luis Diaz.
Marianito Adames.
Bryant Navarrete.
Anthony D. Green.
Amy Feliz.
Ayendi Rodriguez.
Osasu Igebor.
Anthony Benitez.
Ken Formi.
Safa Al-Saidi.
Rasha Hassan.
Okay. Ermira Nimaneye.
Brian Ferreras.
Joshua Rivera.
Samantha Stewart.
Rosemary Torres.
Samuel Medina.
Priscilla Joy Alexander.
Brittany Rose Montalvo.
Trinidad Magalan.
Aferdita Gashi.
Blerta Nite.
Urbana Pena.
Jesse Terrero.
Alyssa De Gracia.
Alpha Omar Ba.
Isayaka Darbo.
Mohammed Yassin Islam Chowdhury.
Sumatea Orubanga.
Audrey Hedges.
Shaquana Blair.
Claudette Johnson.
Rosabel Garcia Rodriguez.
Natalie Velez.
Rosa Batista.
Francie Sanchez.
Kimberly Rose Vega.
Sergio Arias.
Carmen Cruz.
Niselis Rodriguez.
Jennifer Munoz.
David Santana Jr.
Paul Soto.
Department of Public Safety's Elvis Farfan.
Elisa Garden.
Jose Manuel Arias.
Marisol Meza.
Lizbel Vargas.
Yasmalina Salvador.
Rocio Morel.
Okuchi Favor Dubusi.
Gina Monsan.
Anissa Lewis.
Jelini De La Rosa.
Chelsea Toombs.
Carlette McKenzie.
Michael Setabudi.
Alexander Whiteside. Elided Nebo.
Yulema Munoz.
Biadelka Vargas.
Cristel Vicente.
Victor Arias.
Christian Nava.
Joshua Delgado.
Kenesha Henry Williams.
Misa Ahmed.
Jessica Perez.
Shahi Akhtar.
Pamela Paulino.
Raymar Marte.
Yeah, Raymar! Woo!
Chelsea Fuentes Campos.
Oh, Junior. Junior Cabrera.
Victoria Jane Dominguez.
Agustin Garcia Flores.
Jessica Diaz.
George Skrills.
Brian Cortez.
Gina Samuel.
Elijah Will Estrada.
Mandango Sakwe Tibil Sakwende.
Joan Concepcion.
Samantha Livingston.
Nastasia Polanco.
Nicole Maria Perez.
Courtney R. Johnson.
Barry Johnson.
Ruth M. Sheehan.
Gabriella Burke.
Elton Mahase.
Kalita Cuellum.
Patricia Lizardo.
Julio Fernandez.
Victoria Aguilar.
Naeja Fennell.
Courtney Collier.
Tahira Dawkins.
Betty Ryer.
Heidi Sanchez.
Veda Samaru.
Letty Diaz.
Geraldine Paula.
Cynthia Ramirez.
Rafael Camargo.
Leia Abate.
Caitlin De La Rosa.
Rodney D. Anderson, veteran.
Rudy Ramos.
Amy Marinez.
Christy Bernard.
Gerald Mato.
King Isaac, the zoologist.
Jonathan Xavier Icasa.
Amber Jimenez.
Mikasius Solomon.
William Rojas Rivera.
Antonio Belez.
Soraya Oliver.
Olivia P. and Kali.
Mamiki Zakor.
Darren Thompson.
Montserrat Sonora Bautista.
Ayana Powell.
Jacqueline Hewen.
Simone East.
Sumi Akhtar.
Evanice Desion.
Tariana Rodriguez.
Tasneen Fatima.
Juveria Mohammed Abdul Samad.
Angela Buchanan Bruno.
Jada Parker.
Taslima Chowdhury.
Shanice Anna Soto.
Majeda Yakim.
Jerron Terman.
Rose Kenya Freda Zill.
Thomas Cochilas.
Lorraine Clanton.
Berlinki Felix.
Miguel Angel Herrera.
Jaime de la Cruz.
Alex Fernandez.
Lori Oba.
Charlicia Watson.
Vanessa Bobrun.
Jelani Footman.
Lillian Victoria Ameling.
Diasi Diplon.
Angelica Martinez Navarrete.
Carlina Perez.
Fleva Garcia.
Norma Gonzalez.
Jose Rosso.
Wildari Cepeda.
Jeremy Rosario.
Alba Almanzar.
Brenda de Rosario.
Giselle Guerrero.
Yesenia Barrera.
Yasmin Saleh.
Yomaris Morillo.
David Koulibaly.
Ernest Aua.
Eri Patricio.
Jose Eustate Nunez.
James Javier.
Enilda Santos.
Jatna Moreno.
Alimatu Mensa.
Eric George.
Gloriani Pilar.
Colette Prosper.
Melinda Pearl Simmons.
Banta Sancano.
Siku Cham.
Patricia Phillip.
Christina Ortiz.
Jessica Salgado.
Elizabeth Gutierrez.
Leonel Garcia.
Bianella Grullon.
Jose Cobo, Jacobo Jr.
Shantae Nana Fluff Cox Flowers.
Tasha Maria Cruz.
Nicholas Noel.
Robel Abi.
Jasmine Ruiz.
David Aquino.
Liliana Perez Morales.
Amelia Teresa Melo.
Jessica Beltre.
Joel Garcia.
Robin Ruben James Devoir.
Devin Prevost.
Kai Vega.
Barbara Perez.
Enrique Perez Quezada.
Ogarina Taveras.
Walid Osman.
Don Julio Lopez.
Liza Rivera.
Melvin Castillo.
Misuku Mbewe.
Kathy Lopez.
Nairobi Rosario.
Chayla Jarlene Ramon Rosario.
Fatumata Bajaha.
And the last, Adriana De Leon.
So. This is you.
Congratulations, all of our graduates. Can you give it a Can you please stand? This is the moment you've been waiting for, right? You may now move your tassels from the left side, from the right side to the left side to show recognition of membership into academic community. Congratulations.
All right, so where are we?
BCC.
All right, there you go. You are now former alumni of the college. And to welcome you to this fold is Mr. Michael Williams, president of the BCC Alumni Association, sir.
Greetings, one and all. You've made it. First thing I want to say is congratulations, and I would like for one of you to become the next alumni president. I've been rocking for the last 25 years trying to give back because BCC gave so much to me. Now it's time for one of you to step up and join the Alumni Association, and perhaps one of you be the president. I'm gonna close with congratulations, keep moving, look forward to seeing you soon, especially my veterans, congratulations.
All right now, so you can remain standing because, but you can't leave. For two reasons. Don't be saying I. I heard that. You can't leave for two reasons. One, the order that you came in, we're just gonna reverse that for us to leave. I mean, come on, we gotta be orderly, right? That's right. Do we have to be orderly, yes or no? That's right. Don't be trying to play me up here like that. We gotta be orderly, A, and B, I haven't told you yet where to get your diploma cover. Ah, that's why we gotta be orderly about it. All right, so in order to exit this lovely space, we're going in reverse order. So that means that this platform party exits first, followed by the faculty, and then the students. But we'll platform party, and then we'll take care of the students. You have to follow Shamika's instructions right here. So the front rows are gonna exit first. People in the back row, don't run out first, please. No, he didn't. Everybody good? Am I clear, or do I have to say that again? All right, platform party. Oh, my Lord, I messed something up. Father Sheehan, Father Sheehan, I apologize, sir. Forgive me, we need to do a benediction. You better give me a blessing right now.
So-
Psalm 133 says it all. How good it is when sisters and brothers dwell together in unity. Qué bueno cuando las hermanas y los hermanos están viviendo en la unidad. These words were true when they were first celebrated 2,700 years ago. And it's true today on this gorgeously hot June morning that we celebrate well a real in-person graduation from our great college that survived the pandemic. Being BCC, I think deep down we knew we could survive and bounce back. After all, we are the can-do college, the college with a dream. We are daily open to all our dreams from so many countries and challenging immigrant stories. We ask the Almighty One and the inner power to help us to celebrate the trinity of hard work, imagination, and resilience. Yes, may the Almighty One who has begun this work in us bring it to fulfillment. Amen. Hallelujah.
All right, so we can start with the stage. Start with the straight. He goes, you go. Nope, just go. Straight out the middle. Thank you. And again, the graduates, you'll exit from the rows closest to the stage back. Please don't run out of here. Tell you right now. I won't. Please exit in an orderly fashion. Once you exit Ohio Field, you can go to Meister Hall Overhang. That's where you'll find your diploma covers. Meister Hall, please exit in an orderly fashion and you can go over to Meister Hall. Meister Hall.